got a sweet little Les Paul Standard. Lovely finish. But it's got that thing that I solved before in another one of these, where the covers on the back are creating static electricity and making noise. The first time I did it, it was a bit of a chew because I wasn't really sure how I could correct it. But now I know what to do, and maybe we could just send this video to Gibson and then they can fix their guitars properly.
And apparently somewhere out there they claim that this wonderful bumpy plastic is supposed to be anti-static, but it doesn't work. So what has to happen, right, as I take this off, I'll explain it. I figured it out, and it has to happen in both cavities. The entire back of this cover needs to be coated with copper shielding tape, and then I have to make sure that that cover is grounded to the controls. Sounds fairly straight ahead, but I think it was a little tricky last time getting the ground onto the controls, because I don't think this is old style wiring. I think it's circuit board. Yeah, it's circuit board. You bastards. Alright, so what I really want to do, there's the ground wire for the bridge, so I know that that's ground. So I am actually going to physically attach a wire to that ground wire and make it come up over the edge of the lip of the cavity. That is going to be the solution.
So the same thing's going to happen here. I'm going to make a little ground jumper that makes it way over to this edge, and then that will be all covered in conductive tape and ground the heck out of that piece of plastic. So theoretically, any static it creates, instead of making noise, doesn't exist, it just goes to ground.
Don't you love arts and crafts?
I do.
I made a lot of money in the movies doing arts and crafts. They're sometimes even fun. Actually, I'm going back. I've been invited back. People are unhappy with my retirement. Yeah. Got offered a little job, maybe last a couple weeks, make a fistful of dough. We're going to build a elevator set. So it won't go up and down like an elevator, like a real elevator, but everything inside the little box, all the little lights, and you know, when it moves from floor to floor, the lights have to change and stuff. So I'm gonna go in and fool around with that for a week or so, for an exceptionally large hourly rate. Oh, I hate when this happens. Come on now. There we go. And it's almost time to visit my friends at A1 Electronics here in Toronto, Canada. They actually have a website, but they have the best deals on this stuff. This big roll was really, really inexpensive. Okay, I'll be back. Oh, camera wiggled. We're good. Trim off the crap and do the other little cover. Okay, so next I'm gonna put a little strip of copper on the edge of these cavities, and that will give me something to solder my little jumper wire to, and it'll be permanently fixed forever and ever. Maybe I want to be a little closer to that. Everybody having fun? Join the RC Craft Show. Get the solder a couple wires. I'm going to do a complete setup on this once I solve this stupid issue. What's all that crap? Just crap. Yeah, baby, that's going to be just fantastic. The other thing that's going to happen is that every screw is going to go through that shield. So when I get the meter out at the end, I'll be able to hit those screws and they'll be connected to ground. And in my mind, I mean, there's probably somebody with a lot more scientific knowledge than me, but we've got this plastic, we've got a metal screw, and we've got your shirt rubbing on it, and something bad is happening. Because this ain't the first one, folks. So here, now, even the screws on the plastic covers across the guitar are joined together and hooked to ground. So I'll double check that one time quickly. So if we do this, and we do this, right? Yeah. That is the fix. I am confident. I spent way too much time last time trying to figure out how I could get it not to do that anymore. All right, let's just peel the strings off it and clean up a bit, and it's going to get a complete setup, and away it goes. Let's get these. I'm just going to pull off what's here and start from scratch. I read one comment where someone was questioning why you'd want locking tuners on a guitar that doesn't have a trim. Well, that would be because you can change the strings in about 2 minutes instead of 15. That's why. So now I'm plugging it in to tune it up. I hope you, and look, like the Gibson quality. Why does that, when I touch it, okay, I guess we're looking at something else. Screwdriver, please. Igor? What the hell is going on in here? I have an idea, but so they've put the thing in such a way that the wires are interfering with the spring action of the output jack. But we'll soon find out. So when I remove it from the guitar, why do they have this in here? Well, for some unknown reason, they've decided to use a switching jack. I guess maybe they ran out of parts. I don't know. But the extra lug, that spring, is interfering with this working right. So we're going to bend that out of the way. Well, you folks saw it. That was definitely factory. And like I said, maybe they ran out of parts that day and decided to improvise to keep production going. I don't know. That's the only thing I can think happened there. Because why would you use, you know, Gibson and their knowledge and, you know, money-grubbing ideas? Why would you use a more expensive part than you'd have to? That's a first for me. Great. Now I can tune it up. Straightness, body joint, 7th fret.
I'm loving it. I'm not going to touch it. But we will check it again after we do everything else. Next. String height. What do we got? I thought it kind of sort of looked awful. But we'll find out. Gibson scale's at the 12th fret, folks. And it's sitting perfectly at 5. And treble side should be 3. So that's way too high. Sort of like a lot of my viewers. Well, that should come down even more. Now the stop bar, it's up quite high. I mean, the strings are all off the back of the bridge. This is, you know, there's all kinds of discussions and forums about where this could be and rover wrapping and so on and so forth. I'm going to leave it right where it is because that's the way it was given to me. I don't see an issue with it. There's not a lot of break angle on the strings. Some people think you get more slinkier bends. I don't know. Maybe you do. I just audition guitar players. Right? I only learned enough guitar not to hurt my songwriting. And then I switched to bass and keyboards. So if I want guitar, I get a guy who's a real guitar player. Problem is, when guitar players write songs, it's usually all about guitar and not about a song. That's what I learned. Okay, string height set. Let's retune and pickup height next. Well, I'm thinking about back to this stop bar thing. There is no rule as to how high and low it can go, but there is a rule. The string should not touch the back side of the bridge as they trail off to the stop bar. That is what we know. Oh, pickup height, pickup height. Where are you? Pickup height. Way too close, way too close. And we get to hear the spin of the Peterson Autostrobe 490 tuner. There. Two for two. Three for three. Nice guitar. Nice now that it doesn't all go crackly crackle when you're playing it. Not much else to do now, guys, except shine it up and say goodbye. Thanks for hanging out. It's always a slice. Please subscribe if you really love me and want to help me keep this going the best I can. Become a patron. You can also join the Facebook group, which can be interesting at times. Lets everybody who has things in common interact, laugh at each other a bit, maybe learn something, ask somebody else a question. That's the part I like about the Facebook group. It's like, I really, guys, I gotta be honest with you, I barely have time to go through comments. I mean, if I went through every comment that I get every day across every video, I would start at 9 and probably finish at 6. And that would be just to read them. That's not to respond to them, right? That's a sweet looking guitar. Let's trim the strings. Like I said, all the links are below. If you haven't got a Penny Black CD or a Dave's World of Fun Stuff sticker, well, now's your opportunity. Because you can just click the thing below me. Right, I keep saying that, below me. Anyway, cheers, folks. Be good to each other.